Dr. Shabir, welcome to Let the Quran Speak.
Should I be on?
Now, here's a question from a viewer. What does Islam have against swearing? So the person is referencing Emma Byrne's book, which is called Why Swearing is Good for You, The Amazing Science of Bad Language. Emma argues that swearing helps human beings cope with physical pain, helps with social bonding, prevents violence, and so on. Could swearing have value, the person is asking.
I looked at the book briefly, hesitating to read it because the book itself uses foul language.
Yes. I
see her point, and from a scientific point of view, what she's saying has some validity. But if that's if we take God out of the picture and we take spiritual development out of the picture, and we say, okay, you know, here we are in this world. Under the atheistic worldview, there's nothing to do if you pound, you know, your thumb while trying to hammer a nail in. You know, maybe swearing is better than hitting somebody else. I see that point of view. But do we need to even swear, or do we need to have a different perspective on life here? So there is the anger from which the swearing comes. Can we control the anger before it gets to that, so we don't actually have to swear and we don't have to hurt somebody else? And that's what our religion teaches. The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is said to have recommended that we make wudu, which is a ritual washing that's normally done before prayer. But this washing itself can cool down the person, and the ritual itself gets you into a mood of being close to God and away from things which will be displeasing to God. So one does not have to use expletives and to utter foul things, which we don't like to hear. We don't like our family and our children to hear, and we don't want our children to copy us and utter. We don't want the little boys to say, well, you know, I heard Dad saying this, and therefore I'm saying it too.
So is there anything again within Islam that says that uttering this sort of language is inappropriate?
Yes, there is much. To begin with, the Quran itself tells us about the tongue that God has given us as an amana, as a sacred trust that we have to use in a proper way. And the best way to use the tongue is by saying good things. And the best thing we can do is to speak of the remembrance of God. So the Quran says, فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرُكُمْ وَاشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ. Remember me, I will remember you, and give thanks to me, and don't be ungrateful. The Quran also talks about qawl az-zur, the false speech, and lahw al-hadith, a speech that does not serve any good purpose. So the Quran is actually discouraging us from doing all of these things. And the Quran tells us to stay away from fawahish, which is like corrupt things. And it says, "Zahra minha wa ma batan," that which is obvious from that, and even that which is more subtle. So all kinds of evil things and indecent speech should be done away with.
Thank you for your answer, Dr. Shabir.
You're welcome.